Hello, Qiskiters. My name is Abby Mitchell, and I am a quantum developer advocate working on the Qiskit community team. In this short video series, we're going to cover what you need to know about open sourcing your quantum code and how to join the Qiskit ecosystem. In this video, we're going to cover mostly the what's and the why's. So what is open source? What is the Qiskit ecosystem? And why should you get involved? So let's start with what is open source? Open source is the process of making your code available to the public to view, use, and collaborate on. Software developers will open source their code by making it publicly available on platforms such as GitHub, GitLab, or possibly their own websites. So why should you open source your code? For a few different reasons. The first one is to promote yourself and your work. You've put a lot of effort and you've worked really hard on this code that you've worked on, and you deserve to show it off. Having a strong GitHub profile allows people to see this work that you've done and can also come in handy for job applications when you're trying to show off the types of code that you can write and the skills that you have. Secondly, open sourcing your code encourages collaboration. It enables other people to find your work and also collaborate with you on it. You never know who might stumble across your code on GitHub and have a great idea for how to add to it or build on top of it. Which brings me on to the third reason, which is open sourcing your code can actually make your code better. Your first version of your project is rarely perfect, and making that first version public not only encourages you to write good quality code in the first place, but also enables others to be able to suggest improvements to it. So now I want to talk about why should you open source your research code specifically? There are a few additional reasons that you might want to consider doing this. The first one is reproducibility. If you have written a lot of code that is crucial to the results that you've presented in a paper, others will need to be able to reproduce that. So it's a good idea to make it as easy as possible for people to do that by open sourcing the code base. And secondly, encourage and facilitate comparison and benchmarks. If you have the best optimization for a particular workflow, you should allow others to compare their approaches to yours. And finally, quantum computing specifically is a very cutting-edge technology. It's a super niche area, and we really need to promote collaboration and the sharing of ideas and open science to help push the whole field forward. Okay, so now let's talk about what is the Qiskit ecosystem. The Qiskit ecosystem is a catalog of open source projects, tools, utilities, libraries, tutorials from a really broad community of developers and researchers. The goal of the ecosystem is to celebrate, support, and accelerate development of quantum technologies that use Qiskit. Any open source project that uses one of the main Qiskit packages can apply to join the ecosystem. Ecosystem members also have the option to have regular automated tests run against their project to check compatibility of their project with different versions of the Qiskit packages. So, why should you join the Qiskit ecosystem? For a few different reasons. Number one is to, again, improve the quality and the credibility of your code. If you join the Qiskit ecosystem and configure the automated testing feature, this can highlight to potential users of your project that your work is of a certain level of quality, which can increase trust in your project as a reliable tool for quantum software development. The second reason is through the Qiskit ecosystem, you can easily check your project's compatibility with new and upcoming Qiskit versions. The tests that get run against your project can be using the Qiskit version that you specify in the project itself, but you can also have tests run that use the latest stable and development versions of Qiskit. This means that if an upcoming version of Qiskit breaks your code, you can find out before that version is even released and possibly prevent some issues for your users down the line. And the final reason why you should consider joining the ecosystem is that you can promote your project on the Qiskit.org website. Each project gets its own tile on the Qiskit website, which makes your project more discoverable for potential new users. Okay, so now you know the what's and the whys of open source and a bit of an introduction to the Qiskit ecosystem. In our next video, we're going to cover the basics of how to open source your quantum code, starting from having a project on your laptop to publishing it on GitHub. And then later on, we'll show you also how to join the Qiskit ecosystem. So yeah, thanks for joining everyone. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave any comments if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.